I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
To God.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whose will it is to restore all things in your beloved Son, the King of the universe, grant, we pray, that the whole creation, set free from slavery, may render your majestic service and ceaselessly proclaim your praise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
And please be seated for our first reading.
A reading from the book of Samuel. In those days, all the tribes of Israel came to David in Hebron and said, "Here we are, your bone and your flesh. In days past, when Saul was our king, it was you who led the Israelites out and brought them back. And the Lord said to you, 'You shall shepherd my people Israel and shall be commander of Israel.' When all the elders of Israel came to David in Hebron, King David made an agreement with them there before the Lord, and they anointed him king of Israel." The word of the Lord.
Our response is number 84, "Let Us Go Rejoicing." Number 84. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. I rejoiced when I heard them say, "Let us go to the house of the Lord." And now our feet are standing within your gates, O Jerusalem. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Jerusalem is a city built with unity and strength. It is there that the tribes go up, the tribes of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. For Israel's law is to praise God's name, and there to give God thanks. There are set the judgment thrones for all of David's house. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord. Let us go rejoicing to the house of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, let us give thanks to the Father, who has made you fit to share in the inheritance of the holy ones in light. He delivered us from the power of darkness and transferred us to the kingdom of his beloved Son, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in him were created all things, in heaven and on earth, the visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. All things were created through him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things hold together. He is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he himself might be preeminent. For in him all the fullness was pleased to dwell, and through him to reconcile all things for him, making peace by the blood of his cross, through him, whether those on earth or those in heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Commandment, love one another as I have loved you. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
May the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The rulers sneered at Jesus and said, "He saved others, let him save himself, if he is the chosen one, the Christ of God." Even the soldiers jeered at him. As they approached to offer him wine, they called out, "If you are the king of the Jews, save yourself." Above him, there was an inscription that read, "This is the King of the Jews." Now one of the criminals hanging there reviled Jesus, saying, "Are you not the Christ? Save yourself and us." The other, however, rebuking him, said in reply, "Have you no fear of God? For you are subject to the same condemnation. And indeed, we have been condemned justly, for the sentence we received corresponds to our crimes. But this man has done nothing criminal." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus replied to him, "Amen, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Slogans play a very important part in remembering historic events that occurred in history. For example, in 1836, the Fort Alamo in Texas was attacked by General Santa Anna and 5,000 Mexican soldiers. Every man was killed in that fort. They were fighting for Texas independence. The cry went out, "Remember the Alamo." In 1899, the battleship Maine was in the harbor of Cuba near Havana. Suddenly, an explosion took place. The battleship was destroyed, and a cry went forth, "Remember the Maine." In 1941, the Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor. President Delano Franklin Roosevelt spoke these words, "This day will live in infamy." And a cry went out, "Remember Pearl Harbor." Slogans play a very important part in remembering events in history. You know, even in our ordinary lives, there are times that we remember things, or we want to be remembered. For example, children oftentimes are called after a parent or a grandparent. The family wants to have that name carried on to the next generation. They want that name to be remembered. Sometimes people who are educated at a college, after they graduate and are successful, they in turn want to make a donation to that college that educated them. Sometimes they will have a scholarship named for a person, either in the education field or in the athletic field. They in turn want that name to be carried on. And finally, just take a look at any cemetery. There's always our name inscribed on a tombstone or a grave. We want to be remembered. None of us wants to be forgotten. We want to have people pray for us, remember us, and recall how we touched their lives. When I look at that gospel reading from Luke, I wondered why the good thief was called good. So I did some exploration, and here's what they said. The good thief recognized his position before God. He was acknowledging his sinfulness before God, and he humbled himself. The other thief, on the other hand, was rebuking and reviling Jesus. "If you are truly the Son of God, the Christ, save us and yourself." Instead of recognizing his humbleness before God, he asked God for a favor save us. The good thief turned to Jesus and said, Jesus, remember me when you enter into your kingdom. And Jesus replied, this day you'll be with me in paradise. That good thief wanted to be remembered, especially by Christ. In another scripture passage, Jesus spoke these words, whoever exalts himself will be humbled, but whoever humbles himself will be exalted. Even Jesus humbled himself before God, his heavenly Father. Take, for example, the three temptations the devil posed to Jesus. Each one of those temptations Jesus could have done, but it was not the Father's will. And Jesus came on earth to do the Father's will, not the devil's beckoning. He could have come down from the cross. Imagine the people if Jesus comes down from that cross. But it wasn't the Father's will. The Father's will that Jesus should accept the cross and die on it for you and me. Because of Jesus humbling himself, he too is remembered this day. I hope and I pray that all of us will humble ourselves and admit our sinfulness before God. And maybe God will turn to us and say to us, this day you'll be with me in paradise.
Profess our faith together by reciting the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. We come to the Lord with our intentions, our prayers, our cares today.
For the church throughout the world, that leaders may come to see the wisdom in following the call to respect all God's people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christians be united in Jesus Christ, King of the universe, and continue to build his kingdom here on earth as it is in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the lost, lonely, homeless, and down and out of our society not give in to doubt and despair, but be assured of God's love and care through our ministering to their needs. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish family of Sacred Heart, that we will always be grateful to God for the gift of the Eucharist, his self-sacrificing love on the cross. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace and unity in our world, for peace in our neighborhoods, for peace in our families, and for peace in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We conclude with a prayer to St. Michael on the inside cover of your songbook. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who wander about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Our presentation hymn is number 574, Crown Him with Many Crowns, 574.
Crown him with many crowns,
My brothers and sisters, pray that our sacrifice might be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we offer you, O Lord, the sacrifice by which the human race is reconciled to you, we humbly pray that your Son himself may bestow on all nations the gifts of unity and peace, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you anointed your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, with the oil of gladness as the eternal priest and king of all creation, so that, by offering himself on the altar of the cross as a spotless sacrifice to bring us peace, he might accomplish the mysteries of human redemption and, making all created things subject to his rule, he might present to the immensity of your majesty an eternal and universal kingdom, a kingdom of truth and life, a kingdom of holiness and grace, a kingdom of justice, love, and peace. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end, we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world. Save us, Savior of the world. For
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis I, our Pope, Robert Bruce, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And you may share a sign of peace with one another.
Thank you. live in me, and I will live in you. I will give you living water. Believe in me, and never thirst again. If you love me, keep my commandments. Love one another as I've loved you. Live in the love that flows from the heart of God. Live in the love that flows from the
Our communion hymn is number 816, What You Have Done For Me, 816.
Those who will be bringing communion to the shut-ins, please come forward. As we send these people on our way, on their way with our blessing, would you all extend your hand to show that they represent all of us here in the parish? My brother and sisters, you are sent from this assembly to bring the word of God and the bread of life to the sick and homebound members of our parish family. Go to them with our love, our care, and our prayers. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and gentle healer, amen. Please stand and let us pray. Having received the food of immortality, we ask, O Lord, that, glorying in obedience to the commands of Christ, the King of the universe, we may live with him eternally in his heavenly kingdom, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please remain standing for announcements. Practices for Children's Choir for Christmas Eve Mass will be held on Wednesday evenings in December. They are beginning on December 4th. Details will be in next week's bulletin. Please remember that the Women's Club Euchre Party is this Sunday, November 24, in the Parish Center at 2 p.m. All are welcome. The Athletic Association is selling $25 raffle tickets with drawings taking place for the next 20 weeks. The winning ticket will receive $500 each week. Advent Little Books are available at the doors of the church for you to use during Advent season to spend some time in prayer. Lector books, as well as Eucharistic minister schedules, can be picked up in the sacristy after Mass. Life Choices is taking orders for Christmas cookies in the vestibule. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. Our recessional is number 572, The King of Glory Comes, 572.